is ANOVA. Okay, so for ANOVA, okay, so what is the difference? Before this, we already look on one and two population mean. Okay, so for case one population mean, we will compare our hypothesis with the value of the population mean. Okay, so this is the case for one population mean. And then for two population means, for case independent, so we will compare between two population. For example, we have gender, we have male and female. This is the example for your project. Okay, for example, our objective is to study the difference in mean satisfaction towards library between gender. Okay, so when we have two population, for example, male and female, so we will use independent sample test. Okay, so when we write our hypothesis, so we will compare the mean satisfaction between male and female, and then for your alternative hypothesis, either the mean satisfaction for male is less than female or more than female or difference than female. And then for two population mean, for case in the dependent for mu d, so for our hypothesis, we write our hypothesis. So this one that can be mu d lah. Okay, that's me. Right. And now for today's class, we will look on if we have more than two population mean. For example, we have faculty, FSKM, FSG, and education. So we have more than two population. So we cannot use independent sample test. So kita akan guna ANOVA. Okay, so for example, to study the difference in mean satisfaction toward library between faculty. So before this, we want to look on the gender. So now kita nak tengok on faculty. So since we have three faculty, so we cannot use this one. So kita akan guna ANOVA. Alright, so how to write your hypothesis? Okay, so for hypothesis, your H-null is still sama. Okay, for your H-null, it must be equal. So since we have three faculty, so we said that the mean satisfaction for FSKM, FSG and education is equal. So mu1 is equal to mu2 is equal to mu3. Or you can write your hypothesis if you don't want to let 1, 2, 3. So you akan buat mu FSKM is equal to mu FSG is equal to mu education. Okay, so you can write either this one or this one. Okay, and then for your H1, okay, so for your alternative hypothesis, the berbeza sikit. So for your H1, dia akan jadi fixed. Okay, so this one is fixed, which is at least two treatment means are differ or unequal. Okay, or we say that at least one pair of treatment means are differ or unequal. Okay, so you can write either one. Okay, at least two treatment means. Okay, ataupun you kata at least one pair of treatment means are differ. Maksud one pair dekat sini, either mu1 unequal to mu2 or mu1 is unequal to mu3 or mu2 is unequal to mu3. So we doesn't know which pair yang unequal. So we just say at least one pair of treatment means are differ. Okay, so this is for your hash 1. Okay, you can write either at least two treatment means are differ or at least one pair of treatment means are differ. Okay, so this is for your H1. Okay, and then yang this one kita akan tengok on next week lah untuk test of independence or chi-square. Okay, so for ANOVA, okay, since we know that we have more than two population means, okay, kita akan guna ANOVA. So this is the introduction for one-way analysis of variance. Okay, or the short form is ANOVA. So for ANOVA, it's used with one categorical independent variable and one continuous variables. So that means for ANOVA, we have one categorical variable. Okay, and then another variable is on numerical variable or continuous variable. Okay, so for example, we have faculty. Okay, so this is categorical. Okay, kita ada contohnya FSKM, FSG, and education. And then in numerical variable, for example, we want to study on the CGPA. Okay, so CGPA is a numerical variable. Okay, so kita akan tengok based on CGPA. So kita ada two variable, faculty and CGPA. So one variable must be categorical, and then another one must be numerical. Okay, so if both variable is a categorical, for example, we have faculty and gender. Okay, so bila you ada two variables ni memang dua-dua categorical, so we cannot use ANOVA. Since the rules or the condition to use ANOVA, one must be categorical and another one must be numerical. So if both variables are categorical, so yang ni kita akan tengok on the next one lah, independent test of independence or chi-square test. Okay, so last subtopic kita akan tengok on this one. But for ANOVA, you must be remember, okay, it must be one categorical independent variable and another one continuous variable or numerical variable. Okay, so dekat sini dia kata the independent variable can consist of any number of group or level. So that means contohnya dekat sini, okay, for example you want to add another faculty, okay, contohnya FKE. Boleh, tak ada masalah. So nanti when you write your hypothesis, so you just tambah je lah mu 4. Oh, kat sini tambah mu FKE. Okay, so ataupun ada lagi nak tambah boleh. Okay, so kalau ada 7, 7. Kalau ada 10, 10. Okay, dia tak ada limit. Right, so that is for your H9. Okay, so dekat sini dia kata can consist of any number of group. Okay, tak kisah the sample size. Okay, and then ANOVA is a method where the total variation or variability in the set of data are partitioned into several components. So nanti kita akan tengok on ANOVA table how they partition into the several component. Okay, and then this is the assumption for ANOVA. Each of the group must be random sample from normal population, and then population variance must be equal, and then the sample of randomly selected is an independent. So maksudnya for each faculty ni, there has no relationship lah. Okay, tak berkait. Okay. And then kat sini kata to test the equality of mean that involve more than two population mean. Okay, so that's why we use ANOVA. Okay, so this is introduction for ANOVA. And then next, we look on the terms that we use in ANOVA. Okay, so you akan learn another, a new terms. Okay, so for the first one is respond variable or your dependent variable. Okay, so for your respond variable is a variable of interest to be measured. Okay, so that means untuk respond variable, the variable must be numerical variable. Alright, and then for factor or independent variable, or we call it as treatment. Okay, so your independent variable is the variable whose effect on the response variable. Okay, so since kita punya response is numerical, so your independent must be categorical. Okay, since we have one categorical and one numerical variable. And then the next one is factor level. Okay, iaitu values of the factor utilized in the experiment. So your factor level or another name is number of treatment. And then we denoted our factor level as K. So K is the number of treatment or our factor level. So how many levels or how many factor in the variable? Okay, for example, in this one, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So our factor level is 5. We have 5 factor level. And then the next one is treatment. Okay, so treatment is the factor level of combination. Okay, so untuk treatment ni actually it is the same as your factor or independent variable. So maksudnya dekat sini dia kata the treatment is a factor level of combination. Okay, so maksudnya untuk factor level dia adalah untuk this 5 lah. Dia dah combinekan the factor level. So we have 5 factor level, which is faculty, and we know that faculty is our independent variable, okay, categorical variable. So that's why our treatment is the factor level of combination. And the last one is experimental unit, okay, which is the object on which measurement is taken. So I will show you an example for this one, okay. So, for example, we want to study the difference in CGPA between program in FSKM. Okay, So we have four program. We have CS251, CS253, CS255, and CS259. So we know that we have two variable. This is the first variable, okay, and then this is the second variable. Okay. So for CGPA, we know that CGPA is numerical variable. Okay, so this is your response or your dependent variable. Okay, so that's why your dependent or response variable is CGPA. And then program, so we know that program is categorical variable. So that's why your program is your independent or your factor or your treatment. Okay, so if the question asks you what is the independent or factor or treatment, so program is your factor or your treatment. Okay, and then if the question asks you, okay, the factor level or the number of treatment for this case, for this study, so we know that we have four program. So that's mean our number of treatment is 4. Okay, our K is 4. Okay, and then the number of observation, so we have another terms. Okay, so for your number of observation, your N. Okay, so for your number of treatment is how many level or how many treatment we have? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. But for number of observation is the all sample size in the data. Okay, for example, this is our data. Okay. So ini tadi this is our program and then this is our CGPA. So CGPA is numerical. So we have for CS251, kita ada 3.7 for the first sample, the second sample 3.8, for the third sample is 4. And then for CS253, so we have 3.9 for the first sample, 3.6 for the second sample, and so on. So for number of observation, we will calculate all the samples in the data. So maksudnya kita ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9. So this is your number of observation, your total sample size in this data. Okay, so that's why dekat sini your number of observation is 9. And the last one for experimental unit, so for experimental unit is students lah. Okay, so this is what you want to study. Okay, you want to study about the students. Okay, so this is how to differentiate between these terms. Okay, so make sure you can differentiate what is the response variable, what is the factor variable, what is the number of treatment or factor level, and what is the experimental unit, and also number of observation. Okay, so we will look on another example. Okay, on these terms. Okay, so let's see, they kata a greeting company wanted to use a coupon offer to increase sales. So they developed 4 different coupon design. So we have 4 different coupon design and use each design with a number of customer. So they took a sample of 8 customer for each design. So tadi we have 4 design and then for each design we have 8 customer. Okay, and noted their purchase amount as a result of the coupon. So the purchase amount is our numerical variable and our coupon design is our categorical variable. Okay, so did the coupon have different effect on sales? So we know that our independent or factor variable is coupon design. So we have 4 different coupon design. So kita ada coupon design, kita ada 4. Okay, we have 4 coupon design, 1, 2, 3, 4, and kita ada a sample of 8 customer for each design. So for each design, okay, so this is your coupon design. And then our numerical data is on the purchase amount. So this is your purchase amount. For example, for design 1, for the first customer, since we have N until 8. Okay. So for example, for the first customer, they buy 3 design for the first design. And then for second customer, for example, 5. Okay, so just example, contoh. And then for the second coupon design pun sama. Okay, maksudnya kita akan ada each design tu, we have 8 customer. Okay, so the purchase amount depends on the customer lah, dia beli berapa. Okay. So this is the example for how to apa nama itu graphical our data ni. Okay, kita ada four coupon design and for each coupon design we have eight sample customer. Okay, there. So this is your dependent or response variable purchase amount. Okay, and then independent your coupon design and then your factor level. Okay, so we know that factor level is the number of treatment. So this is our treatment coupon design. So we have four coupon design, one, two, three, and four. So that's why dekat sini factor level you is four design. Okay, and the last one is experimental unit customer. Okay, so we have another term which is number of observation. Okay, our N. So in this case, how many number of observation? Kita ada berapa number of observation?
32.
32. Okay, good. Okay, since we have
Right.
four design and then for each design we have eight sample, so we have 32. Okay, so this is your number of observation, right? So this is example on how to differentiate between these terms. All right. So now we will look on the steps, okay, how to answer the hypothesis testing for ANOVA, okay, one-way ANOVA. Okay, so the step is still the same. You need to write your hypothesis until your conclusion, okay, but for your hypothesis, you will refer to the questions, okay. So if you have four, in this example, we have four faculty. So when you write your hypothesis, mu one, mu two, mu three until mu four. So if you have five, so until mu five lah, right? Follow the questions. Ada berapa the categorical variable, okay? And then your H one, at least two treatment means are differ or unequal, or at least one pair of treatment means are differ. Okay, you can use either one lah. Okay, tak payah tulis dua-dua. So this is how to write your hypothesis. And then for your test statistic, okay, we will use F calculated, okay, or you can use, so this is the first one, or another one you can use P value. Okay, so if you use F calculated, use formula. So sama, the third step you need to find the critical value. So now we will refer to F distribution. Okay, so for F distribution, if you look on the table, okay, the distribution statistical table, the value is only a positive value. Okay, kita hanya ada positif sahaja, kita tak ada negative side. Okay, so when you calculate your F calculated, okay, make sure you get the value positive value. Okay, so if you get your F calculated negative, so must be something wrong lah. Okay, maybe you punya calculation ada salah. Okay, you mesti dapat nilai dia mesti positif. Okay, positive value only. And then for your critical value, okay, so how to find your F calculated, you need to construct ANOVA table. If the questions do not give ANOVA table or SPSS output, so you need to construct ANOVA table by your own lah. Okay, so how to construct the ANOVA table, I will show you later. Okay, so this is the formula for F calculated, which is your mean square for your treatment over mean square of your error. Or another name for mean square of treatment is variance between group. And then while for mean square for error, another name is variance within group. Okay, so this is another name for this one. And then for your critical value, so we will use F distribution. So this is your alpha, and then this is your V1, and this one is your V2. Okay, so if we look on the F distribution table, so we have two degree of freedom. Okay, this is your V1, your first degree of freedom, and this is your second degree of freedom. And then you akan nampak this four row. Okay, so what is means by this four row? Kat sini dia kata is tabulated for alpha 0.05, 0.025, 0.01 and 0.001. And dia kata 0.05 is the value being bracketed. So maksudnya this one is for your alpha 0.05 for the first row, the second row is for 0.025, the third row is for 0.01 and the last one is for 0.001. Okay, so for example, if the question asks you to find the value for 0.0523, okay, So to read from your statistical table, you need to read first the value for your V1 and V2, and then baru you check your alpha. So in this case, our V1 is 2, so you need to check 2 first and then baru 3. Okay, so we will find the value in this one, okay, in this table. So the question asks you to find the 0.05. So we know that 0.05 is on the first row, so the answer is 9.55. Okay, so this is how to read the value for your F distribution. So you need to find the degree of freedom first, and then the second degree of freedom, then baru you tengok your alpha. Okay, either 0.05, 0.025, 0.01, or 0.001. Okay, so that is how to find the value. Alright, and then for decision rule, okay, since we know that our case is only on the positive side, so we only reject our hash null if F calculated is more than our critical value. Okay, so we only have one decision rule, and decision we will compare between this value and this value. Okay, so if the value is more than, we reject. If the value is less than, we fail to reject. And then conclusion, there is enough or not enough evidence. Okay, so this is how to answer the question, hypothesis testing questions for one-way ANOVA. Okay, so now you want to know how to find the value for F calculated using ANOVA table. Okay, so this is your ANOVA table, a one-way analysis of variance, right? So for ANOVA table, you must have 5 column and 4 row. Okay, dia mesti fix. Mesti ada 5 column and 4 row. So untuk the first column, source of your variation, and then the second column for your sum of square, and then the third column for degree of freedom, and then the fourth column for mean of square, and the last one is your F calculated. Okay, so to construct your ANOVA table, you need to solve this column first, and then baru you boleh continue to the next and next column. Alright, so how to find the value for this one, your source of variation for treatment, error and total. So this is the formula. Okay, so this is the formula for each one. Okay, so if you look on this table, so I have two, okay, two name kat sini. Okay, the first one is between group, another one is treatment. So what is the difference between these two? If you look on your SPSS output, okay, if you run your ANOVA table, okay, so nanti bila you run nanti, bila you run SPSS nanti, so kalau you run SPSS, dia only have between and within group. Okay, dia tak ada kata treatment and error. Okay, but we know that this between group is equal to our treatment. Okay, so formulalah treatment dalam case tu apa benda. For example, dalam case this one, our treatment is program. So this is our treatment. Okay, so when we construct our ANOVA table, so kat sini kita akan guna program lah. Okay, as our treatment. Alright, so kalau SPSS dia akan tulis between group. Okay, so for the second row is within group or your error. Okay, so how to find the value? So we will use this formula, and then the last one is your total. Okay, so for total, okay, so how to find the value for this column? First, you need to find the value for sum of square for treatment or between group. So this is the formula. Okay, so you need to find the value, the total value for each program or each treatment, and then how many sample size for each treatment, and then you will minus your, this we call it correction factor. Okay, so bila you calculate, you akan dapat this value. Okay, and then the next one, you need to find first the value for your total sum of square, your SST. Okay, so how to find the value? So this is the formula. Okay, you need to find the summation of x square minus summation of x square over your number of observation. And then baru you can find the value for your sum of square for error, which is the formula is your SST minus your SSB. So you akan dapat this value. Right? So once you already get all these values, then baru we look on your degree of freedom. Okay, so to find the degree of freedom, so this is the formula. So we know that the K is our number of treatment, okay, and then N besar is the number of observation. Okay, so kita tengok kepada this example dulu. Okay, so for example, for this example, okay, so if the question asks you to test, for example, at 5% significant level, test is there is a mean difference in CGPA between program in FSKM. Since we know that the program is more than 2 population mean, so you cannot use apa namanya itu population mean lah. Okay, so kita akan guna ANOVA. But if you only have CS251 and CS253, so yang itu baru you boleh guna population mean. Yang mana nanti bila you write your hypothesis, you akan buat your hypothesis macam ni je lah. Okay, since we only have 2 population. Okay, but if you have more than 2 program, so you need to solve the problems using ANOVA. Okay, so in this case, this suruh you test at 5% significant level whether there is a difference in CGPA between program and FSKM. So this is how you write your hypothesis. Okay, mu 1 is equal to mu 2 is equal to mu 3 is equal to mu 4. And then your H1, we say that at least 2 treatment means are differ. Okay, so this is your hypothesis. And then for the second step, your F calculated, so you need to find this value using ANOVA table. So you need to construct your ANOVA table. So how to construct the ANOVA table? Okay, like I said before, you must find this value and this value first, and then baru you boleh dapat this value. Okay, so I will show you how to find the value. Okay, so the first step, you need to list the value for total for each treatment. Maksudnya, you need to find the total for the first treatment or for the first program. So you just add up 3.7, 3.8 plus 4. So you will get your total for the first treatment. Okay? And then you cari the value for the second treatment, the total for the second program. So 3.9 plus 3.6. So you will get the second value. And then the third value. So you just add up these three. And the last one, you just have one value. Okay, so that is for your total for each program. And then you need to find your summation of x and summation of x square. So how to find this value? So you will use this one, okay, calculator, and then you tukar macam biasa, mode SD, but you need to substitute all this value, 3.7, 3.8, 4, 3.9, 3.6 until 4, until the n is equal to 9. And then you tekan shift 1, and then you dapatkan the value, this one. And then for summation of x square, so you tekan shift 1, 1. So you will get the value. Okay, so you will get this value. Okay, this one and this one. Okay, so this is the first step. You need to list down all the value. Then, Mari, you substitute this value into the formula. Okay, so to find this value, so ingat, this is the formula. Okay, to get the sum of square for the treatment or between group. So this is the formula. So just substitute the value into the formula. Since the first program, the total for the first program is 11.5. Since we total up these three value, we get 11.5. And then you need to square the value. And then over N1. So how many sample size in the first program? So we have 1, 2, 3. So that's why dekat sini N1 is equal to 3. Okay. And then for the second one, okay, for the second program, so we have 3.9 plus 3.6, so your T2 is 7.5, so you need to square the value, okay, 7.5 square, and your N, since we have only 2, so your N is 2, okay, and then for the third one, samalah, you total up, and then over 3, and the last one, 4 square over 1, since we only have one sample size, okay, so kalau semua tally, for example, sini pun ada 3, sini ada 3, so nanti N dia akan samalah. Semua akan jadi over 3, over 3. Okay. So, and then minus. summation of x square over n. So your summation of x is this value. You square kan over your number of observation, your total for all your sample size. So you will get this value. And then you will get the value for your sum of square for the program. So you will get this value. Okay, so this is the first value that you already calculate. And then the next one, you need to find the sum of square for the total. So what is the formula? So this is the formula. Okay. So just substitute the value, since you already find the value for your summation of x square and summation of x. So just substitute the value and then you will get this value. So you just masukkan je dekat dalam table. This one is the value, right? And the last one, your error. So we know that to find the value for your error, you need to minus your total minus with program. So you akan dapat this value. So 0.1556 minus 0.0439. So you will get 0.117. So this is the value. So you already settle on the first column. Okay. And then we go to the next column, our degree of freedom. So how to find the degree of freedom? So you need to use this formula. Okay. So K is referred to your number of treatment. So in this case, our K is 4. We have 4 program. So 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Okay. So yang ni you tak payah sure pun tak apa. Tak ada masalah. Okay. So your first degree of freedom for the program. So 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. And then for error, your number of observation. So we have 9. Minus K, so your K is your number of treatment. So 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. And the last one, the degree of freedom for total. So your N number of observation is 9. So 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. Okay, so this is for the third column. And the fourth column, for mean of square, we only find the mean of square for program and error. So untuk total ni tak adalah. So how to find the value for mean of square? Okay, you need to divide your sum of square for treatment divide by your degree of freedom. So you will get this value. So maksudnya this value 0.0439, you divide by 3, you will get 0.0146. Okay, so how to find this value? 0.0439 divide by 3, you will get this value. And then for mean square of error, okay, so sama, for mean square of error, how to find the value? You need to divide your sum of square, okay, for this one, over your degree of freedom, then you akan dapat the value. Okay, so this one nak dapatkan value dia 0.1117 divide by 5, you will get 0.0223. So we know that this is our mean square for our treatment, and this one is your mean square for your error. Mean square of treatment, mean square of error. So to find the F calculated, you need to divide this value with these values. Barulah you dapat your final answer for your F calculated. So to find 0.6547, you need to divide 0.0146 divide by 0.0223. So you will get this value. Okay. So how to find this value? You akan bahagi ini dengan yang ini. Okay. So this is how to construct your ANOVA table. Okay. If the questions only give you this data, so you need to do from the start lah. Okay. You kena construct. But if the question already give you the SPSS output, so tak ada masalah lah. Okay. Kalau dah bagi SPSS output, so you just use the value. Okay. But if the question do not give you the SPSS output, so you need to construct by your own lah the ANOVA table. Alright. And then that is how to find the value for your F calculated. And then the next step is your critical value. So for critical value is F alpha K minus 1 N minus K. So we know that K minus 1 is our V1 and then N minus K is our V2. So if you look from your ANOVA table, so we know that this is our V1, this is our V2. Okay, so you just masukkan lah 3, 5. Then tadi kita suruh test at 0.05, 3, 5. So you baca from the table, 3, 5. 3 and then 5. Okay, so kita tengok dekat sini. And then 0.05 is 5.41. Okay, so this should be the value. And then decision rule reject H null if F calculated is more than your critical value, then we compare our F calculated with our critical value. Okay, kita akan compare these two value. So since we said that F calculated is less than our critical value, so we fail to reject our H null. Since we only reject our H null if your F calculated is more than your critical value. So when we fail to reject our H null, we say that the CGPA for both for all programs is the same. Tak ada beza pun. So kita, bila kita buat conclusion, kita just cakap there is not enough evidence to conclude that there is a difference in CGPA between program in FSKM. Okay, so this is how to answer the hypothesis testing for ANOVA. Okay, so dia banyak sikit lah steps dia, since where untuk find the F calculated, so you need to construct your ANOVA table. Okay, but if the questions already give you the SPSS output, for example, macam ni, dia dah bagi dah dekat you SPSS output, so you can take the value from the ANOVA table. So this is your FCAL. Okay, so you no need to construct from the start. Okay, just take the value from the output. Okay, and then your significant is your p-value. Okay, but if the questions only give you this data, so you need to do from the start lah. Okay, so you need to find all this value, and then you need to find the sum of square for your treatment, your total and your error. Okay, so we look on the example in slide. Okay.
Miss, can you repeat for F calculated again? Just that part.
Apa dia? Mana?
Can you repeat for F calculated again? The last part on how to get that final value.
Oh, this part. Alright, so since we know that the formula for F calculated is mean square for your treatment over your mean square for your error. So now we already find our mean square for our treatment. Okay, so this is the value. And then this is the value for mean square for error. Okay, so to find the F calculated, you need to divide this value. 0.0146, you divide by 0.0223. So you akan dapat this value. Okay, since this is the formula. Okay, to get the F calculator, you need to divide mean square for your treatment over mean square of your error, which is the value is this one. Okay.
On the all right, got it. Thank you.
All right. Okay. So now we will look on the example in the slide, example 4.13. So kat sini dia kata 15 fourth grade students were randomly assigned to the three group. So we have more than two groups. So automatically, you know, you will answer this question using ANOVA. Okay. To experiment with three different method of teaching. Okay, so kita ada three different method of teaching, arithmetic, and then at the end of the semester, the same test was given to all 15 students. Okay, so this is your total sample size, your N. Okay, the table give the score of students in the three groups. Okay, so kita ada tiga group. Okay, we have three method 1, method 2 and method 3. So this is your independent or your factor, and then this is the score. So this is your dependent, okay, which is your score. So this one is categorical, and then for dependent is numerical. Okay, the data is in numerical. Okay, you dapat dalam bentuk nombor lah. Okay, number. And then at 1% level of significance, okay, is there is sufficient evidence to indicate that the mean arithmetic score of all fourth grade students taught by the three method is same. Okay, so we know that this is the question for hypothesis testing, so you need to do all the step from your hypothesis until your conclusion. So in this step, okay, the first step is your hypothesis. So how to write your hypothesis? Okay, so your H null, since we have three method, Okay, so your h null mu 1 is equal to mu 2 is equal to mu 3. So this is what we need to claim ataupun we need to test. Okay, either the three method is same. And then for h1, so h1 is fixed. We say that at least two treatment means are different. Or are unequal. Okay, so this is the first step, your hypothesis. And then the second one is your f calculated. Okay, so since the questions do not give you the value for your f calculated, so you need to construct your ANOVA table. So how to construct your ANOVA table? Okay, so you need to find the value for your t1. Okay, you need to find the value for t1, t2, the total for your method 3, and then your summation of x, summation of x square, and your n. Okay, so how to find the value for t1? So you need to add up 48 plus 73 plus 51 plus 65 plus 87. So what will be the value for your t1, the total for your first treatment for method 1?
324.
All right, good. Okay, 324. And then for the second method, what is the total? The total score for the second method?
369.
Okay, so this is the value. And then the last one for method 3?
388.
Okay, 388. Okay, so for the next step, to find the value for your summation of x and summation of x square, so you can use calculator. Okay, mode SD, so you need to substitute all the value. Okay, or you can just add up this 3 1. 3 to 4 plus 3 6 5 plus 3 8 8. So you will get the value for summation of x. Or you can also use your calculator. Okay, mode SD tu, you masukkan all this value. So you akan dapat the summation of x. So what is the total of summation of x?
1081.
Okay, 1081. And then for your summation of x square, so if you already substitute your value into your calculator, so you can just apa nama itu, tekan yang shift 1 and then 1 lah. But if you don't want to use your calculator, you tak nak guna this one, so you need to square each data. Okay, you kena squarekan each data, and then you can find your summation of x square. Okay, you can use manually lah. 48 square plus 73 square plus 51 square plus 65 square until 67 square. Okay, or you can use yang mode SD tadi lah. So you can get for both value ni. Okay, mana-mana tak kisah, so kan you dapat the value. Okay, so what is the value for summation of x square?
80,709, correct? Okay?
Yes, betul. Right? Right. So this is the value. Okay, and then the last one, your n, we know that we have 15 students. So this is your sample size, right? So after you get all the value, so you need to find your sum of square for your method, for your treatment. Okay, so how to find this value? So you need to use this formula. Okay, formula this one. So, kita kena cari the sum of square for method. So, how to find the value? So, we need to sum up all this value. And 2 plus, since we have only 3 method. So, sum to 3 method. And then, our correction factor. Okay. So, just substitute the value. So, we already calculate the value for your T1, T2 and T3. And then, we know that the n for each method is the same. We have 5. Okay, so kat sini dia akan jadi 3 to 4 square over 5 plus 3 6 9 square over 5 plus 3 8 8 square over 5. And then minus with, since we already find our summation of x square over 15. Okay, so to find the value here, so this is the formula. Okay, so what will be the value for your sum of square for your method. So make sure you get your value in 4 decimal places, right? Okay, so 432.133. All right, good. Okay, so this is the value for your sum of square for your method. Okay. And then the next one, okay, so this is the value 432.1333. Then the next one, we need to find the sum of square for total. So how to find your sum of square for total? So the formula is summation of x square minus summation of x square over n. Okay, so this is the formula. So just substitute the value. Since we get our summation of x square is 8709. So this is our correction factor. Okay. Square over 15. Okay. So you find your sum of square for total. Yes. Okay, so that is the value. Okay. And then the last one. Okay, so this is for total. So this should be the value. Alright, so to find the error, so we know that for sum square for error, you need to minus your sum of square for total minus with sum of square for method. Okay, so you need to minus this value, okay, dengan this value. Okay, so what will be the value for your SN? 2372.8000, right? So that is the value. 2372.8. Okay. So this is how to find your sum of square for method error and total. Okay, so the next one is for your degree of freedom. So for degree of freedom for method, so the formula is k minus 1. Since we know that our number of treatment, we have 3 methods, so our k is equal to 3 and our number of observation, your n, is equal to 15. So in this case, to get the value for your degree of freedom for method, so we know that the formula is k minus 1. So the number of treatment is 3. So 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Okay. So this will be the value for your degree of freedom for your method. Okay. And then for your error, so for your error, we know that the formula is number of observation minus with your number of treatment. So we have 15 number of observation and 3 number of treatment. So 15 minus 3, so what will be the value? Dapat apa? 3. Eh, sorry, 12. Okay. Alright. And the last one, the formula is your number of observation minus 1. So we have 15 minus 1, so the value is 14. Okay. So this is how to find your degree of freedom. And then the next one is how to find your mean of square. So you know that to find the mean of square for our method, we need to divide 432.133 divided by 2. Okay, so what will be the value? Yes. Okay. 216.0667. And then for this one, you need to divide 2372.8 over 12.
All right, okay, so this is the value.
And the last one, your F calculated. So we know that our F is this value divided by this value. So 216.0667 divided by 197.7333. So you will get your F calculated. So what will be the value?
1.0927.
All right, so this is your value for F calculated, 1.0927. So this is how you find your F calculated. Okay, so you need to construct your under part table first, and then baru you boleh dapat this value. So make sure when the questions only give you your data, make sure you show all the calculation. Okay, this one you kena show lah macam mana you dapatkan this table. Okay, and then baru you write your value for your F calculated. Okay, so the third one is your critical value, okay? So for your critical value, so we know that the critical value is your V1, V2 or K minus 1 and minus K. So sama je lah. Okay, ni your V1 and then this one is your V2. So the question asks you to test at 1% significant level. So F0.01 and then your V1 is 2, your V2 is 12. Okay, so you try find this the value from statistical table. What is the value?
6.93.
Okay, so first kita tengok dulu 2. Okay, 2. And then kita tengok 12. Okay, this one. And then the question asks you to find 0.01. So it should be on the third row lah. Okay, 6.93. And then continue macam ni lah. Okay, so we compare this value with this value. So we said that since F calculated 1.0927 is less than your critical value, so we failed to reject our HNAL. Since the question asks you either there is a difference in the three method, either the three method is the same. Okay, so this is the questions. And then when we test our hypothesis, we fail to reject our HNAL. We say that memang dia equal for both, for the three method. So when we write our conclusion, so kat sini kita kata, okay, kita just cakap je, there is enough evidence. Okay, to conclude that, the mean arithmetic score of all fourth grade students taught by the three method is the same. Okay, so macam tu je lah. Okay, so this is how to answer the questions using F calculated. Okay, but if the question given you the SPSS output, so you have this ANOVA table. Okay, so macam I kata, for ANOVA table, dia akan bagi dekat situ between group and within group. Okay, so samalah ni membawa maksud method, and then this one is your error. Okay, so the value ni dia akan sama je lah yang macam you kira tadi. Alright, so this is your V1, this is your V2, and then this is your F calculated, and this is your P value. So for P value, just take the value. Tak perlu nak bahagi or darab by 2 ke, tak kisah. Okay, just ambil the value. Okay, so for example, this is the value is 0.366. Okay, so that is the value. And then dia punya step dia sama je. Okay, first your hypothesis. This one is your hypothesis, and then the second one is your p-value, and then your alpha is 0.01, and then we have no critical value, so you go to your decision rule, rejection if p-value is less than or equal to alpha, and then we compare our p-value with our alpha, so kita akan kata fail to reject HNAL. So your conclusion akan sama lah. Okay. Okay, so if the question give you SPSS output and the question do not mention any method, so you can choose either use F calculator or P value. Okay, but if the question memang bagi ANOVA table tapi dia tak bagi P value, okay, they only give you the F calculator, so nak tak nak you must answer using test statistic lah. You use F calculator. So you kena tengok jugalah ANOVA table tu dia bagi value yang mana. Okay, so that is how to answer for ANOVA. Right, so we look on the last example. Okay, so this is example 4.14. So kat sini, in a comparison of a strength of a concrete produced by 4 experimental mixes, 3 specimens were prepared for each type of mix. So we have 4 mix, A, B, C and D. And then dia kata kat situ dia dah bagi dah. So given SSE is equal to 0.02 and mean square for error is 0.003 with a degree of freedom of 8, construct an ANOVA table for the above experiment. So the question already give you the value for your SSE. Okay, dia dah bagi untuk row yang ini. Dia dah bagi dah 0.02 and then the degree of freedom is 8 and then the mean square is 0.003. So you just need to find the value for sum of square for mix and sum of square for total. Okay, and then you find all the value and then you get your F calculated. And then the next question ask you to test at 5% level of significance. Can it be concluded that at least one of the concrete differ in average strength from the others? Okay, so yang ni you akan continue lah, start from your hypothesis until your conclusion. Since your F calculated you already find in A, okay, dah cari dah dekat A, so nanti value yang ni you just continue dekat your B lah, your part B. Okay, just substitute nilai F calculated yang you dah kira daripada this one. Okay, so for your hypothesis, okay, since dekat situ dia bagi mix A until D, so kita akan kata for your hash now, kita akan guna mu A until mu D lah. Okay. And then hash 1 dia akan jadi at least 2 treatment means are different. So you try construct your ANOVA table first and then you get your F calculated and then you solve the question until conclusion. Okay? So you try to look this question. Oh, kita ada another one example. Okay, tak apa. You try first this questions. Okay? So nanti kita akan discuss first. So you need to find the TA, TB, TC, TD. Okay. Summation of X, summation of X square and then your N. And then after you dah dapat that value, so you just masukkan dalam formula. So you just need to find your sum of square for mix and total. Okay, since for error, the question already give the value. So you just need to find this value and this value. So nanti at the end you will get your F calculated is 1.6667. Do you understand? So untuk sum of square for mix and total dapat sama tak? So make sure this value you dapat the correct value. So if you get the wrong value, so until you have calculated you will get the wrong value. Okay, so dapat sama tak for your ANOVA table? You will get sum of square for mix is 0.015, and then for total is 0.035, and for your degree of freedom, so for mix, since we have four mix A, B, C and D, so 4 minus 1 is equal to 3, and then for your degree of freedom for error, so your N, capital N minus with your K, so we have number of observation is 12, so 12 minus 4 is equal to 8. So this one already given in the equations. And then the last one for your degree of freedom for total, your number of observation minus 1. So 12 minus 1 is equal to 11. So to find your mean of square for this one, you need to divide 0.015 divided by 3. So you will get 0.005. And the last one for your F calculated, so you need to divide 0.05 over 0.03. So we'll get this value. Okay. So for B, so you need to solve the hypothesis testing. So this is your F calculated that you get from your ANOVA table. And then for your critical value, since the question asks you to test at 5% level of significance, so this is the value 0.05. And the value for your V1, V2, you can get from your ANOVA table. So this is your V1 and this is your V2. And then when you read from your statistical table, you will get the value is 4.07, and you will compare your F calculated with this value. So kita kata since F calculated is less than, so we fail to reject our H null. Since the question asks you either at least one treatment means is differ. Okay, so since we say that we fail to reject our H null, so our conclusion, there is not enough evidence to conclude that at least one of the concrete differ in average strength from the others. Okay, so this is how to answer example 4.14. And then we look on the last example. Okay, example 4.15. So this is another example for ANOVA question. Okay, the question already give you the partially completed ANOVA table. So you need to complete the missing value. Okay, so for A, the question asks you to complete the ANOVA table. So since in this question, the question already give you the value for your summation of treatment and total. So we know that to get the value for your error, so you need to minus 45.2 minus this value. Okay, so in this question, so you need to subtract this value with this one. So what will be the value for your sum of square for error? 45.2 minus 18.4.
26.8.
Okay, so this should be the value. And then for your degree of freedom, so we know that this is for k minus 1, this one for n minus 1, and then this one is n minus k. Since in this question, we do not have a data, okay? So how to find your n minus k, your degree of freedom for your error? You can minus your degree of freedom for total minus your degree of freedom for treatment. So maksudnya 41 minus 6. So you will get 35. Okay, so this is the value for your degree of freedom. So maksudnya you can also get the value for this one. Okay, so how to get the value? So you can minus, okay, 11 minus 3. So you will get 8. Okay, same goes to this questions. Okay. So nak dapatkan 12 ni, you can minus 14 minus 2. So you will get 12. Okay. So to find the missing value in this ANOVA table, so you just minus 41 minus 6. So you will get 35. Okay. And then for this one, so how to find the value? So 18.4 divided by 6. So you will get the value. So what will be the value for your mean of square?
3.0667.
Alright, so this is the value. And then the next one for mean square for error, 26.8 divided by 35.
0.7657.
Alright, so this is the value. And the last one, your F calculated. So to find the value, you need to divide this value with this value. Okay, and then you will get your final answer, your F calculated. So what is the value?
4.0051, is it?
Alright, so this is the answer. Okay, so you already complete the first question. Okay, complete the ANOVA table. And then the second question, show how to obtain variance between sample. Okay, so how to find your variance between sample? So remember your variance between sample. Okay, so we know that this is another name for your treatment is between group. And then for error is within group. So when the question asks you to obtain the variance between sample, so we know that another name for variance between sample, okay, is mean square between sample. So maksudnya this one lah, mean square between sample. So another name is variance, total variance between sample. And then for total variance, total variance within sample, okay, another name dia adalah mean square within sample. So if the question asks you to find variance between sample, so kalau variance between sample is this one, kalau variance within sample is this one. Okay, so in this case the question asks you to show the value for variance between sample. So dia just nak yang ini. Okay, you just show how to find the value. So for B, you just show it lah, 18.4 over 6. So if the question asks you to how to obtain variance within sample, so kalau dia tanya pasal within sample, so kita akan show this one lah. Okay, so this one is variance within sample. So in this question, dia tanya variance within sample sahaja. And then the next question, how many treatments involved in the experiment? So the question asks you to find the value of K. So, what is the value for your K? Yang ada berapa?
7.
Right, so your number of treatment is 7. And last one, how many number of observation? Your N?
42.
Okay, so this is how to answer ANOVA table. Okay, so if the question asks you to ni, make sure you show lah. Sini maksudnya kita show, kita tahu that K minus 1 is equal to 6, so to find K is 7. And then for D, N minus 1 is equal to 41, so N is equal to 42. Okay, so that is for ANOVA. So nanti you can try a tutorial questions for ANOVA. So for tutorial questions for ANOVA, kalau you check for the previous past year, okay, ANOVA table, for ANOVA questions, the question only start from June 2018. Okay, and then usually the questions dia selalu dia selang-selang. Okay, population mean independent dengan dependent. So for example, in that semester, the question asks you the hypothesis testing or confidence interval for population mean for independent. So maksudnya if the question asks you this question, okay, so nanti dependent tak ada masuk, so dia tanya this question. Okay, ataupun the questions only ask you independent and dependent, ANOVA tak ada. So usually dia selang-seling macam tu lah. Okay, so kalau untuk for ODL questions, so far untuk last two semester, nanti I will send you example for ODL punya final assessment yang open book. Dia lain sikit lah, soalan dia lebih tricky sikit. Kalau macam you tengok yang pasti ni, dia macam direct sahaja. Okay, sebab you tak boleh open book. Okay, so kalau yang open book tu dia macam tricky sikit. Nanti I will send you the past two ODL final assessment. You boleh tengok lah contoh. Okay, so nanti you can try a tutorial for question ANOVA. So for example, this one, they just suruh you compute all the value. So make sure if the question is 3 marks, so for R ni, you can just minus the value. Okay, but if the question asks you to use, for example this one, to use a formula, and then if you look at the marks is 5 marks. So you need to show how to get the value. So you need to show this one. Okay, you substitute into the value. But kalau you tengok the first questions ni, kalau ini nak buat all the value pun you tak boleh nak buat, since the questions do not give you any data. So you can find, you can't find the value for this one, your A, B, C and D. Okay, so you just minus the value. Okay, so for B, state the null and alternative hypothesis. So you just state your H null and H1. And then for C, based on the p-value. So for C, no need to write back your hypothesis. Just terus continue with your p-value. Okay, so tak perlu nak tulis balik your hypothesis. There is no marks for your hypothesis, since we you already write your hypothesis in B. Okay, so for this question, okay, state the null and alternative hypothesis for this study. So kita nak tahu apa namanya itu, dia punya null and alternative hypothesis tu. So kita tahu dia fix je lah. Okay, since we have four, so mu A, mu B is equal to mu C, is equal to mu D, and then for H1, at least one pair of trinomials are different. Okay, and then you test. So this is your p-value macam biasa. Okay. So the questions kalau contoh macam ni, dia guna f-test. Since there is no p-value, so you need to use f-test, f-test lah. Okay, f-calculated. And then for this one, since the questions do not give you any method, so you can choose either f-calculated or p-value, since the output already give you the value of f-calculated and significant your p-values. But nak mudah, you just ambil p-value je lah. Okay, tak perlu nak check on your statistical table. And then the last one ni pun, dia dah cakap based on p-value, so follow lah guna p-value. Okay, so you can try this question. So nanti we will discuss on next week lah. Okay, next week kita akan discuss on this tutorial, and then we will look on the last subtopic on topic 4. Okay, so is there any questions? I nak tanya apa-apa before we end our class?
No, miss. Thank you.
Alright. So, kalau tak ada apa, thank you for today. So, don't forget to fill up the attendance. So, see you next week. Thank you.
Alright. Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you
so much.